Hello, so I got my first ever sewing machine for Christmas, and I've been dying to use it because I've always wanted one, but I've never used one before. I got the genius idea to take two identically sized shirts in different colors and kind of make like half shirts out of them by painting sun and moon sort of stuff on them. It's a very loose interpretation, but the circles are remarkably even given the fact that I measured them using a plastic jack-o'-lantern instead of like a bowl or something like a rational person would. I also got really, really nervous when it came time to cut them in half because I really liked the paintings. I don't know why I thought I would sacrifice something so precious for my first sewing project, but it's a good thing I pleasantly surprised myself in the end. my posture's so bad. No wonder why my back hurts. I was using a zigzag stitch, by the way, if you're curious. I guess that's pretty good for, like, t-shirt material, from what I learned. I had both of the shirts, like, sewn together, and I was like, it kinda needs some more oomph. So I thought about, like, cutting off the bottoms and switching them out. I played around with some configurations, and I finally settled on one crop shirt and one really long shirt, and, that's what you're seeing in the finished product here.
There are two types of people in this world. You are either... or
I did not expect that video to be so popular, but here's part two of edible alternatives to forbidden foods. Broken glass, I'm so with you. It looks so crunchy. A great and like actually really close alternative for this is if you make hard crack candy, just like pour it on a sheet of wax paper, break that bitch, bite into it. Delicious. The one for aquarium gravel is so simple. You just take nerds and you put them in a glass jar so it makes that clinking noise, and then you can shovel them into your mouth with reckless abandon. The crunch of a Tide Pod is something I dream about. Unfortunately, the solution for this is only for those 21 and up, but if you are 21 and up, Google Whiskey Pods. It's these with alcohol in them. Are you craving a dangerous blue liquid, but Blue Gatorade just isn't spicy enough? Add something really, really sour to Blue Gatorade, and that should do the trick.
I know that look. You just killed someone.
I'm gonna go find Finn. A dancing bug.
Fine, fine. You can have it. Will you pry it from my golden hands?
I think I was visited by aliens again.
Quack. Want to pet my dog? He lives at my house.
Fall.
I'm literally just trying to mind my own business. That's very nice. Do you want to hear more about the American coup?
Fucking no.
No, why not?
Because I'm Irish! I live in Ireland!
Well, that's an important political event.
I can't keep up with the politics in my own goddamn country because all I'm shown is American politics and the amount of bullshit you get up to is exhausting.
Yeah, that is fair. Some of the protesters at the coup can't get home because they're on no-fly list, so they're just kind of stuck there. That's kind of good. Do you have any more?
Yeah, people are trying to make Mike Pence into the good guy.
What?
I know!
What's the strangest thing in your fridge or freezer?
Okay, me. I win this one. I win this one, guys. I win this one. Running. It's outside. I win. Can I flip this around? Yes. This is what's in my freezer.
Infectious waste, danger.
So I can't actually show you it because TikTok community guidelines, but this is my amputated left foot.
I know I'm not the only one who's enjoyed the level of anonymity that the masks give you so people don't recognize you in public, but let me level you up really quick. The mask beanie sunglasses combo! Ooh. Yes, baby, give us nothing!
Someone just called me Ricicum in the comments, N-I-D-K? If they just misspelled Ricicum, or it's a really good insult.
I'm gonna give you one chance to say exactly what you just said before I expose you to TikTok.
Jesus' name, when he was born, was Joshua. Like, canonically, it was Joshua.
Fucking canonically! Canonically to the Bible storyline.
No, canonically to history!
That's not a thing! That's... Do you know what people call canonically to history? Historically! Historically, his name was Joshua. Fucking canonically. He rose again in a cave,
hey,
guys!
It was a story! The story
his sister
Jesus.
Was a witch!
Canonically!
You met my little fella? Oh no, he don't bite. What makes you have that idea? He's friendly as can be.
This is your daily reminder to never get into a fight with a gay person. It doesn't matter how small or like weak they might seem. Every gay person has an unlimited amount of internal suppressed rage that they can access at any point, no matter how calm they seem. And I'm just gonna give you an example of what that looks like. I'm not angry right now. I'm actually completely calm. I'm even gonna just sit like this, you know? Don't fight gay people.
And what in the Lester Oaks Construction Worker do we have going on here? We have chicken tenderloins chopped up into little bits, smashed down into very, very flat pieces until it's one big mass seasoned with salt and pepper. It looks like in the microwave. And one bit, they're chicken chips. They're chicken chips.
The sound of me being stylish as fuck.
I'm angry, so I'm gonna make a cat out of socks.
Lay a sock like so, draw a little design, sew all along the lines, cut it out, cut a little hole here, use that hole to flip it inside out. Stuff him. Body. Sew hole closed. Ta-da. Set him aside, other sock. Draw that. Sew it. Cut it, and then cut along here. Flip inside out again. It's a head. Stuff him. Sew him closed. Head done. You're gonna sew him on top of the hole you made in the body. He. Tail time. Take the rest of that sock, draw that. Sew along here, leave this open. Flip him inside out. Tail. Sew it. Yeah! I'm running out of time. Beat eyes. Yeah, he's a little wonky, but considering he was birthed from rage, it's not too bad.
By far, one of the most defining moments of the 21st century is this photo, and it's not even edited.
What happens to the music during a car crash?
Does it stop, or does it just...
It keeps going.
When I got in my first car wreck, PewDiePie had just released a new meme review video, so I was listening to it on the way home just to like have something playing in the background. And then this lady hit me, and my car spun and flipped, so the EMTs had to come pull me out of my car. And I was screaming and crying and freaking out because it was my first car wreck and it was pretty bad. And all that was in the background was PewDiePie going, meme review!
Oh, yeah, she did green.
Yeah.
Call an ambulance, but not for me.
Sit down,
Frank.
Stand up,
Frank.
Pass out,
Frank.
Wake up, Faded.
Okay, so I know we talked about how everyone either looks like a rat or a mouse, but I have another proposition. Every single man exists on an axis between rat and thumb. But this is a compass of appearance. So on this axis, you have rat to thumb, and on this axis, you have Muppet to chewed gum. So for example, I'm pretty far on the rat Muppet quadrant, or let's say like Chris Pratt is like definitely thumb and like a little bit Muppet, or like I couldn't think of a better example for like rat chewed gum than like Benedict Cumberbatch. And you could be like pretty neutral on one of the axes, so you could be like thumb with no strong leaning. It's like the political compass of ugly men.
People are passing by my car, and I was thinking, why are people looking at me like I'm crazy? It's because you can hear this shit at full blast.